This is the full build of the Master Grade Extreme Strike Freedom Gundam exterior pieces. Okay, I've got all the pieces off the runners, so we're ready to go ahead and do the build. So, according to the manual, after doing the inner frame, then you would go right to the backpack, but instead what I'm going to do is I'm going to jump ahead and do the armor, which gets attached to the inner frame, because that way I've got everything unassembled here so that I can put the pieces on by section. And then when I'm done with the putting the armor on, I can put it back together. And then when I finish the backpack, then I can go ahead and just put that on the piece once it's finished. Now, one thing that's a little bit different, that for this one, instead of other models based on either the Freedom or the Strike Freedom, is that the waist assembly section does not include the rail guns, because it is just for the armor. There is a completely separate section for the rail guns themselves. So I just want to let you guys know that, so you didn't think that something was missed if you've done one before or watched my Super Deformed, MG Super Deformed Freedom kit build and wondered where the side rails were. So let's just get right on into this. Okay, we'll go ahead and start with the head. And even though this is a Master Grade Extreme, there are a lot of little tiny pieces. I mean, the color separation on this is going to be insane, considering how many different pieces are used to put together very simple areas. It's going to look great. So, let's see here. Oh, wait, put the face thing on first. That spot sounds pretty nice. Okay. Alrighty. There's a little long peg, you know, a thin rectangular peg that goes into a slot in the back of the head. So once you get that in, everything else will come into place. There we go. Just be patient, it'll go in. put this on first. It's a painful little piece. Not painful, but just a pain to put on. Wow. Nothing to clean it onto except for the peg that goes in. That's not gonna help. I didn't see it back under that slot. There we go. That's what I need to have. There we go. And then some goes. Cool. That's beautiful. Look at all that detail. Oh, that inner frame showing through, and yeah, that's amazing. Okay. Let's go ahead and do the chest. Now, you'll notice that for many of these areas, there's very little armor to actually put on. Because most kits, part of your area build is also doing the framework, and this had done that as a separate thing. So putting these things on should go fairly quickly. Of course, I just jinxed it, but that's okay. There are what they call the metallic decals, the stickers that will go on as well throughout the build as detail pieces.
Guess it wouldn't be a build if I didn't forget something that I needed and had to retrieve later. So easy to work with when they go into a recess. That's exactly fit to them. Okay. Gotta move the waist fully forward, or fully the back fully up, in order to reveal where this snaps in. There we go. And then of course it fits beautiful. Push it back, and they'll nest right underneath. Unfortunately, the small ones are a bit of a pain to work with. Hmm. This is when you wish we had three arms, three hands.
Okay. Okay. I'll make a third hand. These things would rather stick to the tweezers than to come off. Okay. With a little patience, it eventually gets there. Okay. Okay. That nearby. Okay. A couple of shoulder pieces here. Let's see. These go on here. They're the same piece. It's not like there's a right and a left one. Oh, good. More decals. It's this one. Okay, so 16 and 17.
big under gate. There is nowhere. No, because then that would prevent that. Yeah, it's just a big under gate. Okay. Oh, now I see the curve on it. I wasn't sure if those were pegs or undergated. You can normally tell what's undergated because the undergate will either just be big, long, rectangular, or if it's small, it'll have, you can see a circle or a half circle shape, which isn't the way that most pegs are. But this one was so small, I couldn't quite make out the, it was so big, I couldn't see the curve because it was very subtle. Okay, there we go. Very nice. And this one as well. Why I've learned to keep the nippers in my file accessible when I'm doing the build, because there will inevitably be a nub that I missed. Snap in, maybe not. I guess not. Okay, I guess it is on. Okay. It's and this goes on top of there to hold that down. And then these go where I was putting them before. And that is the chest. Cool. Put the head on. Very nice. Okay. Now the arms are duplicate
there are no special pieces, so there really isn't a right and a left one, but I did arrange them that way. And of course, that includes the shoulders. So,
this gets pushed up. Not as far as we'll go. Okay, just so you can get to the forearm. Or under gates. Okay. Okay. And then we can put that down and put on this right here. See, slide those so we can have access to here. And it is, oh, they are up.
Once you have it on the right side, it will fit just fine.
it won't fit the other way. You can't put it on backwards. That's that, and we twist this around again. Oh, it's just so bad. This is supposed to look after it's put together. Okay, this isn't very helpful.
That's what that graph. Okay, you gotta push this up out of the way. That's what the graphic is trying to show there. So then you can slide this. Right in here. Down. Okay, you slide it from the top. Okay. And then that can fit right back down there. Okay. There we go. This. Oh, that's cool. Okay. And that covers up those. Okay. Once I knew what the graphics were showing, it was easy to put that together. I just wish this had more than just like an arrow. Because it's the same type of arrow that makes it look like it's just being twisted. Okay. Alrighty, so the shoulder now. This go right in there, and then these This is beautiful. I'm going to say that a lot during this build. Yeah, that happened. Okay. Now the left arm. Remove some nubs. Okay. And away to put the side pieces on. Okay, time to put these in the wrong section. Down. There we go. Apart. Alrighty, let's go ahead and do the waist.
Okay. I was not expecting this to go there, but no. That's so cool. Oh, okay. So this. Right there.
Alright. That is the waist. Okay, now the legs and the feet. And once again, these appear to be just just duplicates. They're not mirror images or anything like that, so you don't have to worry about which is left and which is right. As far as the armor is concerned. There is still a right and a left. Okay. As far as, you know, the hips are concerned. But we're not putting armor, I don't believe, on the hips. Or where it connects. I could be wrong. Oh, that's interesting. Okay, they got the armor going on with the legs still on, but new way. Okay. Excuse me. Oh boy. So small, I can barely make out which side is green and which side is not. Okay.
It's actually gone underneath the packing.
Okay. Wow. I guess you guys can be the judge on whether you want to do that or not. It does add a little bit of nice little coloration there. And once I got the hang of it, it wasn't all that bad to put on. But, yeah, huh. Interesting little detail there, I have to say. Unfortunately, there's 4 of these pieces, with that means 8 details. So.
It is on there. Is it on there? Oh, gosh. That is.
That's it. That's just a little piece of plastic hanging on there. That's it. Okay. hell got covered up? Okay, another decal. These aren't as small. That.
that's it.
Okay, I think this piece, just looking at the construction of it, epitomizes the amount of detail on this. Because if you think of this, this here is your typical ankle kind of armor pivot point, pivot piece up and down. Which on most models, I mean, we've seen this a number of times. On most models, this is probably just one piece of molded plastic. Normally white or whatever the predominant color of the model is. You might get some fairly detailed panel lining on it at times, like if it's an RG or something like that. But this one here, these are all the pieces and colors that make this up, including having its own inner frame. I mean, this is just... this just shows how much design and care went into making this as good as it could be. Let's figure out how it goes on. Oh, it's supposed to... I see. I'm facing the wrong way. Faces to the... towards the ball joint. There we go. Nice snap to go in. And these things are the vent covers. And where else do you get this much detail on an ankle flare piece? I mean, this is just absolutely incredible. Oops. There we go. Okay, now for the left leg, and I'm probably going to do the rail gun just to get all the hips and everything like that done before I move to the backpack, because these two areas are the backpack. These are weapons, these are backpack, so it's big. There we go. Not looking so bad. Wish I could tell you what I did differently. I think I'm just used to how it feels. Maybe that gave a better angle to it. Let's not mess with what worked. That could be it. Okay, well, one I did, I attached it to a different thing, which was a cross piece, a little bit thicker, so it had a little bit more control. And it turns out that when I set the stand down, it went on top of this piece when doing the other piece. And so I put the other one under there, and it worked pretty well. It's giving me the right angle, I guess. Okay, that wasn't so bad. Almost forgot the decal. Alrighty, that does the armor. There's the armor. Lots and lots of nice inner frame showing. Very nice. Though I do find it interesting that of all the etched metal ones that we put on, that's the only, or in the calf area on both sides, the only ones that show are the ones right there. The other six are hidden, and that's on both legs. But oh well. I mean, even the articulation doesn't seem to show the others. Oh well. All right, let me go ahead and do the rail guns so we can get the hip portions done. And then I can tackle the backpack. Okay. Ah, I see. Just for that little detail, that's cool. can I get this? Oh, I'm putting in the wrong one. Oh. Now these.
I need to put on before.
Okay, that's just an attachment, it's not meant to move. It is tough to get it to seat in all the way. Okay. The other one. There is a key slot in there that you can turn it and it keeps it in place. There we go.
That one snapped in. The other one didn't, but the other one seated properly. All right. And there we go. We've got our two rail guns. So I guess the strike freedom is different. The freedom one was very complex. It's those things that hang to the back. That's cool. The lenses look out front. Nice little detail there. Okay. Hips have a lot of movement in them. And put the side for right now. I'm gonna need a bit of room. Okay, let's just go ahead and do the backpack now. There are a lot of pieces for this backpack. There are 8 blades, so essentially it's, you know, you've got 8 of the same things to put together, with the exception of the middle part that holds everything together, that everything mounts to. And that's the part that attaches to the back of the model. I guess one plus is there's not as many really teeny tiny pieces on this one, on the backpack part. But this backpack has got probably more pieces than many HGs may have. So. Alrighty. And you'll notice that, I mean, the very first thing we do is just the backpack part, but then one thing to keep in mind, there's going to be a lot of 4x and 8x stuff to do in order to get everything done 2x. So just keep that in mind when looking through the manual, that it looks like you're only doing one, but you're going to be doing multiple ones the same way. So. And you have left and right. So that's why it's like 4 and then 4. So they're slightly different on the left side than the right side. If I can organize some of this a little bit here. There we go. Now, there are some etch stickers, but I found that with these, when I was working with them on the inner frame, the glue started degrading because it had been exposed for so long, and probably it didn't help that I had to hold on to the side that was sticky. So I'm going to wind up gluing those on. They would go right in here. I'm going to glue those on at the end. I had to glue a couple of the ones that were in the calf area on the inner frame legs. So I know the glue will work. Okay, that's the middle. And let's start building. The wings. Now, one thing to note is that there's a lot of places in here, especially with the wings, because there's basically, there's right and left, and they're mirror images of each other. So you're going to have a lot of duplicate this 4 times, duplicate this 2 times in there. Here's one with 8, because there's a total of 8 wings. So just keep that in mind as you're building this. It's just a lot of things you got to do over and over again with these. There are those. these things. Okay, that's cool. Helps if I put them the right way. Okay. I see. That mimics those. Okay. Oh, because those don't okay.
And make sure you're working with the right ones, because there are mirror images depending upon which side you're working on. You want the ones with the pegs. There's one of those. Oops. Mm-hmm.
this little ridge when you put them together. See if I can find another one like that. There we go. That's not it. Maybe there aren't another one. Okay, that's the second one of those. Oh, these right here. This ridge right here. That's on this piece here. There's one on each side, and that's what fits into this little slot there, and that helps to guide everything together. If you get the bridge in there, in that slot, then everything's going to fit in together. Oh, there's more bridges on there that fit in up there, so okay, that's cool.
Cool.
Okay. Time to put some blue ones together. Easier if I just sort these into left and right, or front and back, really, I guess it would be. These that hold them in. Okay. And these get slid on. There we go.
There is no particular ones that go on a certain way. Any of the blue will fit in any orientation once you get them in. Thank you. Okay. We go. Off pretty easily. May have to glue that down. But then again, I'm happier it's going to pop off than worry about that later. That's a big, heavy pack. And these are going to constantly fall off, aren't they? Okay. Alright, let's just get the weapons done. Weapons are pretty straightforward. There's just two guns and two beam swords. And then there's the there's also the power shields. Now, the two guns are slightly different from each other, so just keep that in mind when putting it together. Not a huge difference, but there is definitely differences in different pieces at a certain point. Okay. Although a lot of it is going to be the same. Okay. Okay, some more stickers. Oh, I guess I'm going to have to glue that piece in.
Although I don't understand. I guess it can be a side.
Okay.
Those big ones aren't going to help.
Okay.
blue bit. Okay, there's gun number one. Oh, not yet. There's a little ridge I'm finding, so I know which orientation it needs to be in. Okay. That's what I was doing with the other blue one as well. Okay, there's one. Okay. That's a clip, perhaps. Okay. We didn't use all of the decals. That's good. I guess the guns are identical except for the little back part. Okay. Cool. Yeah, I was not looking forward to having to put all these on. I'm glad that there were ones that weren't going to be used. Alrighty. Well, that's it. That's the build of the Strike Freedom Gundam, the second Master Grade Extreme. That was a lot of work, but it was a lot of fun, so I would recommend to anybody who wants to do it, just go right on ahead and do it. There's a lot of pieces, but it's not overly complicated, so thank you very much for watching, and I will see you for the next one. Thank you for watching this video right to the end. If you did enjoy it, please do give it a thumbs up. That does help out the channel. If you would like notifications as to when new videos are posted to this channel, please do subscribe and hit that notification bell. If you do have time, please do enjoy one of the videos that are popping up around my head.